Too prosperous. Want to go somewhere else?
Want a gallon of gas?
The Great Depression started with the disastrous Wall Street crash of 1929, lasting 12 years in the United States until its entry into World War II. Economic growth stalled, economies all over the world began to collapse, while millions here at home lost their jobs, their homes, and their sense of self-worth. In 1933, with up to 28% of the American population desperate and jobless, President Franklin D. Roosevelt created the New Deal, an unprecedented series of programs designed to restart America's stalled economy, relieve poverty and starvation, and put able and willing Americans back to work. These federal programs came to the aid of local agencies which had fought a courageous but losing fight against the growing need for relief. But for many, the dole was not enough. Good, sound men and women wanted to earn the help they got so they could hold up their heads and keep themselves from going rusty. Retail business needed to regain lost purchasing power to stimulate trade. All over America, communities needed improvements in public services which had been cut off or postponed during the lean years when local revenues were pitifully low. The Works Progress Administration was launched late in 1935 as part of FDR's Second New Deal, as the key agency in the federal work program to employ able people from relief roles. Projects were inaugurated and sponsored by local officials who also used local funds to buy materials and supplement the federal money, which was used largely to pay the wages of the workers. Since colonial times in America, artists had been disregarded, about which renowned artist John French Sloan once famously said, "The artist in America is regarded as the unwanted cockroach in the kitchen of a frontier society." Many New Deal programs had an innovative approach to treating artists as workers deserving support. However, the arts programs were constantly under attack as boondoggles and rewardless money pits. A medium that would be perceived as having public worth was needed. That medium was murals. The federal arts program funded 3,750 artists, who produced a total of 15,600 artworks. Artists were encouraged to portray, quote, the American scene. Federal Project Number One was the collective name of a group of WPA projects and contained the Federal Writers Project, the Historical Records Survey, the Federal Theater Project, the Federal Music Project, and the Federal Art Project. With federal funding, art lived everywhere: parks, schools, churches, community centers, and public buildings. By its height in mid-1936, it employed 5,000 mural and easel painters, printmakers, sculptors, poster artists, and art teachers. Art workers came off the breadlines, and art was, for the first time, for the people.